Hi, lovelies. It's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and entertaining simple. Happy New Year. It is the first video for 2018. I hope you had a wonderful holiday season and a very nice New Year celebration. We had about 50 people here for New Year's and it was an absolute blast. It was an 80s theme. So I am recovering from that, or I guess recovered. My son was here for 3 weeks for winter vacation from college. And during that last week, we decided, along with my daughter, Cicely, to repaint his old bedroom. And so now it is a game room. It took us about 8 hours over a span of 3 days because, you know, it's tiring painting a whole room. It was like one coat of primer and two coats of paint. And I will show that to you once I update it a little bit more. So now I have moved on to the small bathroom that they had shared. It actually has two sinks. It's a double sink, but it's a small bathroom. And I started organizing the linen closet. I will be painting it. I'll be painting the doors and accessorizing it a little bit. So I decided that that will be my first series for 2018, is showing you the makeover that I will be doing in the small bathroom. I am upstairs in my home office nook, and you can kind of see that's where the living room and entryway are. These are all the stuff that came out of the linen closet. So I did a little bit of decluttering, probably about an hour's worth of decluttering, deciding what I want to keep, the function that I want to have for this closet. Here are some baskets and stuff that I will be keeping. This is her room. That was my son's old bedroom. That's now the game room. And then here to the left is the small bathroom. We went ahead and got this new shower curtain for her. Here it's a double sink. This is kind of the setup right now. We got her a new clock. And then I will definitely be repainting this. This hasn't been painted for years. It was a flat yellow paint. We are gonna paint it the same gray color, the Miner's Dust Dunn Edwards, that I have throughout the house, just to keep it consistent and to have that neutral color. Behind this door is the linen closet. I have decluttered so much here since I've last updated it. She decided on that shelf liner and then keep the white backdrop. I won't be repainting, but it's basically five shelves. This series is not necessarily a tips and tricks or how to organize, but I'm just going to share my process of how I organize, how I'm making this over, and hopefully give you insights to how I think about approaching a space. That's all the space that you get. When they got to a certain age, I no longer cleaned the bathroom for them. They were well capable, and if it was dirty, it was dirty, and that was that. If it was clean, it was wonderful, and I was happy. But when it wasn't, I just had to be okay with it. And I've already cut out the shelf liner. If you can see the style, that is from Target. That is her duvet cover. We have an extra queen set for her bed. And then these I am getting rid of. They are flat sheets. I don't use flat sheets. And as the fitted sheets have worn out and, you know, cannot be revived anymore, I've kept the flat sheets, so I'm getting rid of those. I'm getting rid of this whole pile. The linens for the guest bedroom are in the guest bedroom, the extra linens. So I usually have one set for the bed currently, and then I have a backup set. So it's two sets together, but only one set will be inside the basket. I usually do the sheets on Mondays, and I wash it in the morning, they're dried, they're put back on the bed the same day. So I don't necessarily need a backup. I like to have a backup example, a newer sheet set for when I have guests, specifically for her bedroom. So I will put that new sheet set like this on that one for the guests, and then when they leave, I'll go ahead and put back her normal one. But I do like to have sheets versus towels. It's just more luxurious when you're, you know, getting ready in the morning. I'm keeping these sheer panels because sometimes I want to do a party, or I have like a canopy and I want to put extra cloth on the side to make it look like a room. So I've done that for different parties. The one that I've already pre-cut. So I'm just going to put the shelf liners in now and then show you what it looks like with all the shelves lined. Okay, I have the first liner in. It would be less obvious having the overlap towards the back. Okay, I've got the second shelf liner in. I've put in all of the shelf liners on all five shelves, and I just cut a strip for the back part to make sure that is all covered. I like how it turned out. The package says that it's gold, so you can kind of see in this yellow light how it looks like. It doesn't glitter or it's not shiny at all. And I just like how it turned out. For these two baskets that I got from Target, I've used this label. It's the Martha Stewart brand that I've had for years. A label on both sides because this is not gonna stay on there. So if it flips around like that, I can see the label on both sides. And then I've used a gold paper clip to fasten it onto the basket. So these are chair covers that you put on those folding chairs like you get from Costco. Here are the tablecloths, and you can see it's the same way that I've labeled. And then this basket is for the king and queen size sheets. This is actually a duvet cover, an extra one for my daughter. And then over here I just have these jars. I filled this one up with mani pedi and spa things. And then this one has Epsom salt, and the other one has magnesium flakes that my daughter uses for softening her skin, for the eczema that she has. Inside is just a scoop I got from the Dollar Tree, and then the Epsom salt also has that scoop. And this jar has cotton balls, cooling eye masks, nail polish remover, and scrubs for foot care. These are my daughter's. My husband has the white ones, I have the gray ones, and then I've just labeled it bath towels. There are hand towels and then these face towels for my daughter. And then the last basket has table runners. This basket holds sheer panels. The most important thing I would say in a small linen closet like this is to definitely declutter. As you see, the king and queen size sheets, there's one extra per bed. The towels are two per person in our home. We have it color coded. You don't have to have it color coded. And then just enough face towels to use for a week. All right, I've got everything in this small linen closet. And again, I only have two towels because one is for using during the week, and then you can wash it while you're using the other one. Once that one is washed, it can go back here into the closet. And as far as the sheets for the bed, one is on the bed and one extra is in here. We just use a day for washing all the linens, and whatever is washed in the morning, it's back on the bed by the evening. Since the linen closet is in my daughter's bathroom, we go ahead and put her towels there. And then her face cloths are right here. These are my towels. I usually have one hanging in my bathroom, and then my face towels are also in my bathroom. And as far as swim towels, we keep them with our swim bags that are in the garage. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Happy 2018. I hope this will be a great year for you, getting decluttered, organized, and having a more simple space and a simplified life, knowing what we're doing and being intentional about what we have. And if you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm waiting long for you. So be my princess for life.